Hello, Brownsburg High School. Thanks for watching BHS TV. Today is Wednesday, January 16th. I'm Kyra Height.
And I'm Chase Bristow, and here's what's going on at BHS.
The Fine Arts Academic Super Bowl team is looking for members interested in music and art for the upcoming season. A call-out meeting will be held on Thursday, January 24th after school in Mrs. Walters' room, 82307. Snacks will be provided if you are interested or have any questions, plan to attend the meeting, or contact Mrs. Walters.
The Math Academic Super Bowl team is looking for members for the upcoming season. A call-out meeting will be held on Tuesday, January 22nd, after school in Ms. Cook's room, 82309. Snacks will be provided. If you are interested or have any questions, plan to attend the meeting or contact Ms. Cook.
Do you think you know history? Do you want to compete against the best historical minds throughout the county and state? Then join the Social Studies Academic Super Bowl team and flex your historical knowledge. This year's topic is Egyptian history, the Fertile Crescent. Any student interested should stop by Mr. Donald's room, B1-210 in the art hallway on Wednesday, January 23rd, right after school. The meeting should last no longer than 30 minutes and all content information will be distributed as well as questions answered.
For those interested in being an MVP on the BHS Science Super Bowl team, Mr. Jones is hosting a call-out meeting after school tomorrow, Thursday, January 17th. This year's academic theme is the Fertile Crescent. They will meet in the Media Center Magazine Lounge after school on the 17th.
AP students, AP exam registration is now open through the Total Registration website. Please be sure to register for your exams as soon as possible. If you have any questions, please speak with your advanced placement teacher. Exam fees are $98 per exam and can be paid online. Even if your exam fee is covered, you must register for the exam through the Total Registration website.
Teens for Christ invites you to join them after school every Thursday from 3 to 4 p.m. in A2413. They are currently studying the Book of Acts and treats will be provided.
Listen up, seniors. It's time to submit your senior quote. You are running out of time to come up with this timeless phrase that will accompany your senior photo forever. Your quote is needed no later than this Friday, January 18th, and will only be accepted via email. Just send your quote to tempoyearbook@brownsburg.k12.in.us. The quote can be no more than 140 characters, the same as a tweet. Keep in mind these have to be approved by administration. No underlying meanings, and if not approved, you will not get a chance to resubmit.
Hey, with recent rumors about prom's location going around the school, Jemiah Thomas went and got some answers.
The accusations of prom being held here at the high school first surfaced when a student discovered the location listed on the BHS website. The students were immediately outraged.
I just feel like that's personally one of the stupidest ideas of 2019, and 2019 just started.
I am at first just a little bit disappointed just because it's my last year, and I feel like you guys should have done a better job for just the fun aspect part of it.
I just don't understand how you gonna have a school that's been under construction 2 years, parking lot shut down because there's nowhere to park, but now you wanna have prom in the gym.
Well, I mean, that's very unfortunate, but you know, life goes on. As long as there's prune juice in there, I won't complain.
Like, after prom, I was thinking about going to Dick's Last Resort with my friends, but no, it looked like I'm gonna have to go to Steak and Shake in a suit. Who wanna pull up to Steak and Shake in a suit?
Prom is always held at the Indiana Rooftop Ballroom. So are the accusations of a location change true?
And I don't feel like it's an accusation necessarily, but it is a realization. Prom will be held in the gym this year, unfortunately.
It's unfortunate because it's been at the ballroom for several years. It's kind of a tradition, but this year is just going to have to be something new. We'll work with it. We'll make it work. It'll still be good.
Psych!
Prom will be at the Indiana Roof Ballroom as always, May 4th.
8 to 11 p.m., $40 a ticket. It's going to be a good time.
We'll see you there.
Hey, thanks, Jemiah. Man, I'm excited for prom, aren't you?
Ooh.
That was petty. Now it's time for sports. Hey, Deontay, what do you have for us today?
Hey, guys, it was a very successful night for Brownsburg Athletics. Let's start things off with the swimming and diving teams who hosted Ben Davis in their annual Bulldog Beach Club last night. The girls team won in a dominating fashion, 148-37, and won every event on the night. Congratulations to Aaron Mayringer in the 200 free, Leah Kingerly in the 200 IM, Logan Rapogel in the 50 free, Julia Stonebreaker in the 100 fly, Jolie Clodfelter in the 100 free and 100 back, Annika Schakel in the 500 free, Abby Callis in the 100 breast, and Emma Wolf in diving. Relay winners include Jenny Dressen, Miranda Peake, Roy Smith, and Elise Dalkey, along with the all-freshman team of Margie Miller, Leah Kingerly, Annika Schakel, and Aaron Hayhawks. The boys also won every event of the evening and finished with the final score of 144-40. Congrats to Nate Sheckle in the 200 and 500 frees, Austin Keir in the 200 IM and 100 breast, Jake Johnson in the 50 free, Caleb Preskin in the 100 fly, Noah Berryman in the 100 free and 100 back, and Cale Davidson in diving. Relay winners included Lee Grimes, Will Scott, Kyle Gannon. Both teams will host Crawfordsville on Thursday. Good luck. The wrestling teams also had a nice evening when they traveled to fourth-ranked Perry Meridian last night. Both the JV and varsity wrestling teams were victorious. The varsity won 43-16 and will travel to Avon Friday for the HEC conference meet. The JV heads to Warren Central on Saturday for JV State. Wrestling senior night against highly ranked Columbus East is now going to be next Tuesday at 6 p.m. in Varsity Fieldhouse. And the girls basketball team hosted Pike last night. The varsity won a hard-fought battle 57-56. After trailing at the half by as many as 10 in the fourth quarter, the Dogs made a great comeback to secure the victory. Allison Bussey made a clutch free throw with less than 3 seconds remaining to put the Dogs on top. The varsity will travel to Westfield on Friday night to take on the Shamrocks. The JV team lost to the Red Devils 51-44. Cameron Leaf led the team with 25 points. The JV will host Westfield tomorrow. And the freshman girls defeated Pike 46-17 and now are 12-2 on the season. Asher Tranter led the Dogs with 13, followed by Megan Kennedy with 10. Nice job, ladies. That's all for sports today. Back over to you guys.
Hey, thanks, Deontay. Now let's check in with Libby to see what the weather's looking like the rest of the week.
Hi guys, we could have some bad weather coming up this week. Today, the high will be around 33 with a low 28 and cloudy all day. Tomorrow morning could be a problem with a 90% chance of snow and freezing rain until about noon. And Friday, again, it'll be cloudy with the high of 31 and some snow possibly overnight into Saturday. Be safe out there. Back over to you guys.
Thanks, Libby. That's all we've got for you today, BHS. Thanks for watching.
Have a great day, and we'll see you guys on Friday.